Well, we need to prove that 1 plus tan square theta by 1 plus cot square theta equal to tan square theta. So let's do that. Now in the left hand side, we have 1 plus tan square theta divided by 1 plus cot square theta. But recall that we had learned two identities. We had learned that 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta. And we had also learned 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. We had learned these two identities. So let's simplify the left hand side using these two. So in the numerator, we have 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square theta becomes equal to sec square theta. And in the denominator, we have 1 plus cot square theta. 1 plus cot square theta becomes equal to cosec square theta. Now sec theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. So sec square theta can be written as 1 divided by cos square theta. And cosec square theta can be written as 1 divided by sin square theta. So this gives us 1 by cos square theta whole thing divided by 1 by sin square theta. So from here we get sin square theta divided by cos square theta. Now sin square theta by cos square theta can be written as sin theta by cos theta whole square. And we know that sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. So this is equal to tan theta whole square. Tan theta whole square is equal to tan square theta. So this is equal to tan square theta, and we have proved it using these two identities. Also note that this is yet another identity because we have proved it for a general value of theta. So this is true for any theta because we have not assumed any value of theta for proving this. So even this is an identity. Now what if you don't remember these two identities? Well, you can still prove it by going back to the basics. So let us take the left hand side. So left hand side is equal to, going back to the basics means convert everything in terms of sine and cos. So 1 plus tan square theta. Now tan theta, we know that tan theta is equal to sin theta by cos theta. So tan square theta will be sin square theta by cos square theta. So this gives us 1 plus sin theta by cos theta whole square divided by 1 plus cot square theta. Now we know that cot theta is equal to cos theta divided by sin theta. So we have 1 plus cot square theta means 1 plus cos theta by sin theta whole square. This is what we have. Now from here we have 1 plus sin theta by cos theta whole square will give us sine square theta by cos square theta divided by 1 plus cos theta by sin theta whole square is cos square theta by sin square theta. This is what we have. 1 plus sin square theta by cos square theta divided by 1 plus cos square theta by sin square theta. Now in the numerator, we have 1 plus sin square theta by cos square theta. So let us take the LCM of these two terms. The LCM of these two terms is cos square theta. So we have cos square theta plus sin square theta divided by cos square theta in the numerator by, in the denominator, the LCM is sin square theta. So we have sin square theta plus cos square theta divided by cos square theta. This is what we have in the denominator. So from the numerator, we have 1 plus sin square theta by cos square theta. Taking the LCM as cos square theta, we have cos square theta plus sin square theta by cos square theta. Similarly for the denominator. So this is what we have. Now we can simplify it as cos square theta plus sin square theta . This cos square theta goes to the denominator. From the denominator, we have 1 sin square theta plus cos square theta. And this sin square theta goes to the numerator. So this is what we have. Now, cos square theta plus sin square theta is the same as sin square theta plus cos square theta. So this and this get cancelled. So we are left with sin square theta by cos square theta, which is what we have here. This is equal to tan square theta, because sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. So sin square theta by cos square theta is equal to tan square theta, which is equal to the right hand side. So we see that we have proved this identity without using the other trigonometrical identities by going back to sin and cos, converting everything in terms of sin and cos. But as you have seen, if we remember the trigonometric identity, then it becomes a lot simpler and we need to solve a lesser number of steps. So we see that remembering trigonometric identity is very useful. Now can you answer this question? Cosec theta minus cot theta whole square is equal to 1 plus cos theta by 1 minus cos theta. Is it true or false? So let us consider the left hand side. Left hand side is equal to cosec theta minus cot theta whole square. Let's convert everything in terms of sine and cos. We know that cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So we write cosec theta as 1 by sine theta. We know cot theta is cos theta by sin theta. So this is equal to cos theta by sin theta. And we need to take the square of this. Now we have sin theta in the denominator in both the terms. So we can write this as 1 minus cos theta divided by sin theta whole square. Or we can write this as 1 minus cos theta square divided by sin theta whole square, which is equal to sin square theta. Now what do we do next? Now look at the right hand side. The right hand side is in terms of cos. So we want something in terms of cos here. The numerator is already in terms of cos. What about the denominator? The denominator is sin square theta. So how do we convert it in terms of cos? Well, recall the identity. Sin square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. So from here, you can convert sin square theta, which is what we have in the denominator, in terms of cos square theta. From here, we get sin square theta as 1 minus cos square theta. So we can write this as 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by 1 minus cos square theta. Now again, 1 minus cos square theta. This is equal to 1 minus cos square theta can be written as 1 square minus cos theta whole square. So this is in the form of a square minus b square. So it can be written as a plus b into a minus b. So we can write it as 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So let's write the denominator. The numerator remains the same. We write the denominator as 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. So we have 1 minus cos theta whole square divided by 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Now 1 minus cos theta, and this is 1 minus cos theta whole square. So this gets cancelled. So we have 1 minus cos theta divided by 1 plus cos theta. In the right hand side, we have 1 plus cos theta by 1 minus cos theta. This is not the same as this, because we have plus in the numerator, minus in the denominator. Over here we have minus in the numerator, plus in the denominator. So these two are not the same. So the left hand side is actually equal to this and not equal to this. Hence it is false. So this is not equal to this. So that is how you can solve expressions involving trigonometric ratios.